readers are leaders, and you know what? Each and every day, you have to find something that will tickle your mind so that you can think. Information, you can't find information if you are not that enthusiastic. If you are not curious enough, you will not be able to find information. And that's why they have always said, if you want to be more knowledgeable, find more information. On a certain topic or certain skill, you have to find enough information, even if it's in business. And that's why I love reading these books. And I'm reading this book. It's called 80-20, The 80-20 Principle. And it's also called the Pareto's Law. And inside this book, Richard explained why this universe, or why everything that we do in this world, will never be balanced. Even if you do what, you will never have a 50-50 balance in this universe. Even if, let's say, like what many people will always say, gender equality, there will be never gender equality in this world, no matter what. And the thing is, you have to accept. The worst thing is when you fight back. For example, if you are doing or you're employing somebody in your company, you expect the person to deliver 100%. But the reality is, it's not possible. The person might deliver 20% or might deliver 80%. So the thing is always, what is the 20% equivalent to? That's why he explains, you can find something that if you have customers, I will use customers as an example. There are customers, there are market that requires a lot of customers. For example, if you are buying tomatoes, the tomatoes are more consumed by many people and they are affordable. This means many people will buy them. But then you can find there are other products that are consumed by very few people, but those products are bought in large quantities. So this one, it means the balance of those quantities are not balanced on the 80% of the customers, but by on the 20% of the product. So the 20% of customers will buy the 80% of the product. That's why it's hard to find a balanced product in this world. And this one, when I was reading this book, then I realized, if I'm not good in something, then it means that I might use another thing to balance where I'm not good at. I can't force myself to be 100% sure in IT when I know I'm not good at that sector. So what do? I make sure that I get somebody who can handle the situation as I balance the other things another way. The good thing when reading this kind of books is that, for example, you get to understand and acquire knowledge that will guide you as you carry out your own businesses. Even in your own business, you don't need to balance your business. You have to find a way to make sure that your business is unbalanced, and it's natural. Many employers will fight to balance their business, but you find out that the business can't balance because, for example, the business is affected by the customers you have. The other businesses are affected by the sales you make. You might have few customers, but many more sales. Then you might have many more sales than few customers. So you find out that if you are not a reader, you won't understand. So if you find out that you have many customers that are buying your product, so where do you focus? You focus on the customer. But then when you find out that you have few customers that are buying that product, then you focus on make sure that the product is good. Because when the product is good, it will generate more sales. And when there is more sales, then there is more revenue. But when the customers are more and the product is few, then you make sure that you focus on the customer so that they don't go away. But people won't understand why you are focusing on the customer. Customers are king. Those are people who decide where your company will be. If you don't have a customer today, you're out of the market. But then a product also is also a place where you need to focus on. So reading this kind of books, I won't dwell into it because some of these things you need to go and find out for yourself by reading these books. Look at how I was and how I am today. Way back, I had less information on something, so I had to find out a way of making sure that I'm on top of my game by reading these books. I know how to balance my content. I know there are videos that I'm not good at, but I try to make sure that where I'm not good at, it doesn't affect where I'm good at, because you have to balance your nature. Even in your families, your kids won't be the same. There are those kids that are more bright and there are those kids that they're not bright. But you don't chase them because they're all your kids. You have to balance your nature. So guys, make sure that you read books. These books will change your mind, will change your thinking. You will change how you evaluate your issues, how you analyze and how you plan. If you don't do that, you always blame the universe why it's not balance. And the truth is, there will be no balance in this world. Even those big companies that they have always fought for having gender equality, there will be never gender equality. I've never seen a company that has 50 employees male, 50 employees female. There will never be. You will always get a plus one, and when you get a plus one, that's not equality. That's the difference. So guys, be curious enough, read books, read information, do research, and make sure that you develop your brain muscles, just the way you work on your body during your workouts. This is your boy, Alan Obi, the billionaire. Peace, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, share videos, like, and you know what? Stay blessed. Peace, guys. Read books.